Today, I'm going to cover how to use intelligent line work in the MEP toolset and how this intelligent line work and the associated layers are different from static line work. If I create MEP system documentation without using the MEP toolset, I use standard lines, arcs, circles, and other shapes. I manually select the layer before I draw the line. Here you can see that layer 0 is selected. Now, I will draw the line with two segments, like this. Without using the MEP toolset, I must, as the designer or engineer, manually assign properties to this line so that I can tell what it is. If I want it to be a duct, I have to manually call it a duct. If, instead, I use the MEP toolset, I actually create objects instead of lines. So, for instance, I will choose the duct object and then draw that same basic shape. But now when I select this line, I see that there is intelligence attached to it. The object line work is automatically assigned to the correct layer. One less thing for me to worry about as a designer, because each object has properties already attached to it. Similarly, when I select this duct, it tells me what shape and size it is. Because of the intelligence attached to this line work, like flow, velocity, and friction, I can use it for streamlining my design calculations. The same is true if I place equipment. I decide what piece of equipment I want and place it in the drawing, like this. This is not a block, or even a dynamic block. When I select it, I can see that it is something called an MVPart, part of the specialized functionality within the MEP toolset. Again, this is a drawing entity with MEP-specific intelligence attached to it. To take this drawing a step further, I can see that this part has connectors assigned to it. And if I click on one of these pluses, it automatically starts adding conduit at the right size and type. And it is automatically assigned to the right layer. This type of intelligent line work is one of the many advantages of using the MEP toolset in AutoCAD.